I believe every American, every grandparent, every parent, every aunt, uncle, you need to make sure your children read Eric's book, Bonhoeffer. Now, I know it's been out for a few years, but this book, actually, I went back and picked it back up and started reading again, Eric. And you do a lot of detail. You do a lot of research into his life. The point being, Eric, and I want you to comment on this, if we were ever in a Bonhoeffer moment or season, we are in it right now in these next 42 days.
Listen, first of all, thank you. The Lord called me prophetically to write that book. I don't say that lightly. Anybody who knows me, the Lord created me in my mother's womb to write that book.
I believe it.
My mother grew up in Nazi Germany. This is my family's history of living through that hell. And when I wrote that book, and I won't get into the details, but the Lord called me to do it prophetically. And when I was writing it, I could feel the Lord saying to me, this is happening. So imagine I'm writing about Germany in the 30s, and I could sort of smell this is happening in America. And now I wrote the book in 2008, came out in 2010. It sold a million copies. I've never had a book sell a million copies. It was translated into 20 languages. A film is being made. It's not directly based on my book, but an amazing, amazing Bonhoeffer film is coming out in November. What is it about this? It's not the book. It's the story of Bonhoeffer is a story of a man whom the Lord calls to wake up the church. And I just have to say, when I was writing the book way back in 2008, I could really sense this is coming to America. And as the years have passed, I've seen it more and more clearly. And if you want to know what is happening and what the church's job is, that's what the Bonhoeffer book is. And I'll say this, Gene, it's kind of funny, but I have heard hundreds of times guys come up to me and they say, I want to tell you, I'm not a reader, but I read this whole book. The story of Bonhoeffer, it's a story for what is happening today. And again, I didn't know quite when I wrote it how the Lord was speaking prophetically. But as the years have passed, I have said, this is clearly God's warning to the American church to say, this will happen again. Evil will rise, and it's the job of the church to speak against it. So especially with the movie coming out, people are talking about it. The book will encourage you because Bonhoeffer is such a heroic figure. It's a beautiful story because he's a beautiful human being who gave his life to the Lord on every level.
Yeah, he sure did. All right, I had the opportunity to preview this film that's coming out, and it's a good film, and we'll talk more about it, but I want to go ahead and play the trailer for you so you can see what's coming about Bonhoeffer this fall. Watch.
Something's coming. Something unstoppable.
Look around you, my friend. How much light do you see?
Hello, darkness, my old friend. I've come to talk with you again. Because a vision softly left its scenes when I was sleeping.
Hate comes in every color.
And the vision that was planted in my brain still remains.
We have devised a plot to assassinate the Führer.
You will go to England as our spy.
Churchill sees Germany as a whole. He's afraid that a bomb traced to England would be invasion or worse.
Invasion? Invasion? My country was invaded from within.
And the people bowed in to the neon god.
Jenna!
my destiny.
Of silence.
Comes out this Thanksgiving. You want to make sure you see that. Eric, when you see the trailer again of that story, what does that bring back up in your heart?
Well, first of all, I think of God's faithfulness. The Lord called me to write that book. I had no idea that it would sell a million copies, be translated into 20 languages, and that it would inspire somebody to make a film.
Right.
And it is for such a time as this. I mean, this is the perfect time. All these years, I've wondered, you know, why don't they make the film now? What about now? It is so obvious that we're in the proverbial Bonhoeffer moment, and that the church, exactly like in the story of Bonhoeffer, the Lord is calling the church to wake up now. And most people who listen to Flashpoint, they are awake. And I hope they're going to churches where the pastor is awake. And if you're not, you're guilty. I'm here to say it. If you're going to a church that's looking the other way while evil rises and saying, oh, we don't go there, you're guilty. And if you want to know the details, read my Bonhoeffer book. You'll see exactly how the enemy succeeded in hiding the truth from people so that they were asleep. And by the time they realized what was happening, it was too late. We're in exactly that moment now. And I praise God that he has given us the story of Bonhoeffer as a very, very clear warning to see exactly what happens. If you're faithful, this happens. If you're not faithful, this happens. And right now, many in the American church are not being faithful. And it's a warning.
It is a warning. And you're right. It's exactly where we are now. And rereading through the book, I skimmed through a lot of it again and realizing just how we really are. It is exactly what we're living through. So I know it comes out in November in the theaters, but I think you ought to get the book. I mean, I'm serious. I really believe this is something that we must pass on to our kids and our grandchildren. All right, so as we continue to go around the room, Pastor Hank, I'm going to start with you because in talking about Bonhoeffer, he was a pastor, but he did more than just preach messages, and that's the true role of a pastor.
That's right. You have to be the moral voice on behalf of the people. But here's what I believe. I feel God on that movie. It's very well done by the trailer. But here's what comes to me. Isaiah 59, in closing. When the enemy comes in, like a flood, the Spirit of God raises up a standard. I believe that movie is a standard that's raised up against the agenda of the enemy. And I believe the enemy's agenda will not prevail.
Amen. I agree with that, too. Chris Ann, your thoughts, final thoughts?
You know, Patrick Henry said, I have but one lamp by which my feet are guided, and that's the lamp of experience. He says, I know no way to judge the future but by the past. God has given us history and memory for a reason,
that's right,
so that we don't have to repeat the mistakes of the past, that we can move forward and have a better life. What I find very compelling is that we are often talking about how in the book of Esther, we are here for such a time as this. But I think sometimes as people of God, we forget that Esther was given a choice. She was given a choice to be a part of God's plan or to not be a part of God's plan. As a matter of fact, Mordecai told Esther, you can choose not to be a part of God's plan, but know that your family will not be saved. God's plan will take place. We are in the day where we are in such a time as this, and Christians must choose God. We must make the choice to become the most powerful control of government that has ever been known to man, the educated, activated body of Christ.
Yeah, good word. All right, Floyd, I'll let you take the next minute.
Yeah, in that trailer, there was a very important and significant line. My country was invaded from within. And you know, it was Abraham Lincoln that predicted that if America was ever to come to her knees, it wouldn't be the result of a foreign army, it wouldn't be the result of a foreign power, it would be because We fell down from within. And that's the problem we had. We let the left capture the schools. We let a generation of young people not learn the lessons of history and not learn the lessons of the Bible. And as a result of that, Gene, we have seen our country go wayward. And as Christians, we have to step up, and we have to step up now and follow what the Holy Spirit is telling each and every one of us to do as part of this struggle for our country.
Amen. Okay, Eric, got 30 seconds.
I just want to say to people, please go to my website. We're going to be sending out a lot of Bonhoeffer stuff. Obviously, you can get the book there, but it's just my name, ericmetaxas.com. This is a God moment in history. I mean, we've lived, all of us, for decades. We know we are in a moment in history like we have never seen, and the Lord is begging us to be His voice. The church was not His voice in Germany. They said, we're going to give it a pass, and hell was unleashed. This is the hour of the American church. So I exhort everybody to do what the Lord is calling you to do right now. Stand in this moment. It's a beautiful opportunity.
It is a beautiful opportunity. Thanks to, of course, my guests today, Pastor Hank Kuhneman, Chris Ann Hall, Floyd Brown, and, of course, Eric Metaxas. Go get the book, Bonhoeffer. You know, we talk a lot about standing up for what's right and not a right versus left. It really is. It's up versus down. Where are you going to fall when it comes to the time to stand up? The quote that we hear often now, Flashpoint Army, I'm going to leave with you. If not us, Flashpoint Army, then who? If not now, when? We'll see you next time.